On the air everywhere, this is New England Broadcasting.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. It's the Ron Van Dam Show.
Hold on tight, things can get a bit weird, if you like that sort of thing.
Hello, welcome to the program. I'm Ron Van Dam. It's the Ron Van Dam Show. Okay. Sons of bitches. Those freaking sons of bitches. I'm referring to Comcast. I don't know how else to put it. I have Comcast cable. I'm not shouting that from the hilltops. I'm not proud of that. Their service is okay. I do like their technology and all that kind of crap. But I got a cable bill in the mail yesterday. I opened up the envelope, and whenever I get a bill, my heart flutters a little bit. I don't think it's a heart condition, although I probably have one. I should by now. But my heart flutters a bit because I don't know how much I owe the cable company at any given time. I pay my bills on time every single month for decades. Decades. And yet, my heart still is a flutter. Could it be love? No, I know the difference. It ain't love. I opened up the envelope, pulled out the cable bill, and I immediately go to the bottom line. Not like, here's your bill, how you doing? Hi, happy Comcast Day. I skip through all that crap. I go right to the bottom line. How much is this bill? It went up $30. What, are you serious? Is this a joke? Do cable companies play jokes on customers? Because if they do, this is very funny. But no. No. It went up $30. And I looked at the details, and it went up $30. So I picked up my telephone. Yes, I have a telephone that isn't a cell phone. I have a landline. I know, that immediately tells you how old I am. It's true. You don't need to ask somebody, hey, how old are you? Just say, do you have a landline phone? Well, yes, I do. Okay, I know how old you are. Okay, thank you. Thank you. That's all I know exactly how old you are now. So I have a landline, and I use a landline when I want to yell at companies and yell at people because I want them to hear me quite clearly. I don't want to miss a trick. Cell phones, the quality isn't good. I'm holding a tiny little disc, kind of square, whatever shape it is, up to my ear. That to me is not solidifying a conversation. I need a hard line, man. I want a hard line to who I'm talking to. No question, no cutting out, no, hey, wait, I lost you. No, none of that stuff. No, I want a hard line, man. I'm a hardliner. So I call up Comcast. I know their number by heart because they're so big they can, like, write their own telephone numbers. It's 1-800-COMCAST. Duh. Where do they get off getting numbers like that? Of course, I don't like dialing a telephone with letters. Then I have to go looking for the letters on the dial or whatever that push-button thing is. That's a pain in the ass. Make it all numbers. Stop with your little fancy little look. If you take all the numbers and you take the letters that correspond, they spell out Comcast. That is so freaking cute, I can't believe it. But I do remember their number, 1-800-COMCAST. I call it up. Do I get a person who answers the phone and says, "Hi, this is Comcast. How can I help you?" No, that's too easy. That's the way it used to be, and we don't do anything the way it used to be. No, instead, I get a robot. It says, "Thank you for calling Comcast. In just a few words, please tell us why you're calling." "Because you suck." Does a robot, are they able to interpret it? "Because you suck. That's why I'm calling." "Do you have your account number handy?" "No, but you suck." "Please listen to our menu as our options have changed." You say that all the time. You've said that for 3 years. Change your robot call thing. It is amazing how the robots are able to understand English. Until you say, "You suck," the robots don't seem to want to hear that too much. They're like Trump. You call me a bad thing, I don't hear you. Wouldn't it be funny if you said to the robot, the robot says, "Could you tell me in just a few words why you're calling?" "Yes, because you suck." And the robot responds, "You suck too." That would be normal. See, then I'd say, okay, now we're into some robot combat here. You know, this is pretty good. Battle of the bots. I like this. Sometimes when I go on websites, it says, "Can you please prove that you're not a robot?" I see. Okay. Have we come to that? Have we come to that in our human society? I need to convince another robot that I'm not a robot. How do we know you're not a robot? Because I'm capable of pure ultra hate for you. Robots can't hate. They don't have emotion. I have emotion. You suck. Can you prove you're not a robot? I never thought when I was growing up at a tender young age that I would ever be asked by anything, "Can you prove you're not a robot?" I don't know how to answer that, other than the absurdity of the question. Anyway, so I say to the robot, "Customer service." The robot continues, "Is it, do you want billing? Do you want customer service?" "You want to speak to a service rep." "Wow, how many times did I have to shout that into the phone before you got it, Mr. Robot? Can you prove that you are a robot? Because you're just as stupid as human beings, so I'm starting to wonder if you're really a robot." So I'm on hold a little bit, not for a long time, I must say. I'm on hold. I don't know. I guess it doesn't take that long to connect my call to telemarketers in India. I have no idea who I'm talking to now. Do you ever ask somebody at a company, where are you located? They will never say the United States. "Oh, we're in Uruguay." "Oh, how's the weather there?" "Fine, Mr. Van Dam. How's the weather in, what do you call that, America? What do you call that place?" Anyway, so I get this person and I say, "Look, okay, my bill went up $30. Can you tell me why?" She says, "Yes, please hold on. Can you please verify that you're you?" "Yeah, because I'm me and I'm verifying it. Who knows me better than me? Yes, I'm verified." And then they asked me a series of questions that I previously gave the answer to 10 years ago, like I can remember what the answers are. And they said, "Who's your favorite school teacher?" I said, "I don't know. Who's your favorite school teacher?" And he said, "Yeah, that's the answer. That's the answer you gave back 10 years ago. So I guess it's you, Mr. Van Dam. Let me take a look at your bill." "Ooh, wow. You're a spendthrift. You must really like TV. We've got you hooked like a largemouth bass here." "You're paying too much, but it's kind of funny." "Yes, your bill went up $30. You were on a two-year a promotion plan, and that's expiring in another year, but your bill's going up $30 because we're getting close to it, and we got to put our kids through college somehow, so we're charging another $30. I said, What? I'm leaving Comcast. I'm going to go to Verizon then. I'm going to go to hell. I'm leaving Comcast. She says, "Well, let me put you through to a special team that can help resolve people who want to leave Comcast." I said, "Fine, put them on. See what they can do for me." I'm on hold for about another minute listening to music that I would never listen to otherwise. And this lady answers the phone. I don't know where she's from, Mars. I don't know what planet she's from. And she says, Mr. Van Damme, how can I help you? I understand that you're billing up $30. I said, yes, yes, and I've been a customer for decades here, and how can you do this to me? Well, the amount of money I've spent on your company as if you owned it. She says, well, I see, Mr. Van Damme, that every time we give you a promotion, you call back 2 years later and want another promotion. And all of a sudden, I didn't know what to say. Yes, I'm playing the system, sister. I do get pissed every 2 years when you raise the price. Yes, I do. She says, well, we've always given you a good deal, but I'm afraid this time we can't. What do you mean this time you can't? That's not what I expect. I expected you'd come up with a lower price, and I get off the phone and go out and drink or something. What do you mean you can't do that this time? She says, well, Comcast has reconfigured their billing levels. And I said, what does that mean in English? She says, the best I can do for you is hold the price for another year, and then your bill will go up again. I said, what are you kidding me? What are you kidding me? Or do you want me to resort to some sort of violence, which I would never do? I'm just saying, do you want me to? Says, I'm sorry, Mr. Van Damme, there's nothing we can do for you this time around. The only thing we can do is give you a different cable box. And we've just set up a corporate arrangement with the Roku people. I said, I don't know who these people are. He said, Roku is a streaming device, and we'll give you $30 off if you do the stream. I said, I want to have what I have. And you not charge me $30 more, and in another year, charge me another $30 more. He says, well, Mr. Van Damme, the only thing you can do is lessen the number of cable boxes that you have in your home. I said, I don't want to lessen the cable box I have in my home. This was such a perfect arrangement. You sent me a bill. I was happy. I paid you the money. Don't you have like a loyalty plan or something where customers have been with you like for 15 years? Get a special price, or do I get some kind of a discount because I live in the proximity of a solar panel somewhere? I mean, do I get some kind of AAA discount? I know the fact that I am a AAA member has nothing to do with watching television. I get that. But do you have some kind of discount for people that recycle, you know, that separate their garbage, the paper and plastics? I mean, do I get any credit for that at all? Do I eat well? Do I get an eat well credit? I mean, is there something you can... She says, I'm sorry, Mr. Van Damme. This time around, you're screwed up the ass like I couldn't even try. I said, oh my God, you usually come up with something. Yeah, but we don't have anything. Let me ask you a question, Mr. Van Damme. Can you live without TV? No, that's why I get the cable thing. I said, I'm going to go to Verizon. She says, well, you can go to Verizon if you want, but they're going to give you a promotional package as well, and they're going to raise the price even higher when your promotional package is finished, and they don't allow bouncing around with different promotions either. And do you enjoy the voice command on your remote, Mr. Van Damme? Well, yeah, I kind of do. I like being able to talk into my TV remote, and then it just goes where I want it to go, and I can tell it that. I do enjoy that. It does make it simpler. Well, Verizon doesn't have that. We're the only ones that do. I said, well, no, that's not true. AT&T has it. And they said, okay, yeah, you want satellite dish on your house? DirecTV, is that what you want, Mr. Van Damme? Do you want to turn your house into a space station? It's not pretty. It's not pretty, Mr. Van Damme. So, oh, my God. Then I'll switch to Verizon, because at least they have a telephone, and when the power goes out, the phone doesn't go out with it. I says, no, Mr. Van Damme, the power does, when the power goes out, you do lose your Verizon telephone line. I said, no, I don't. Verizon is a hard line thing. He says, no, not anymore. No, no. No, the service is through the internet. When you have the internet with Verizon, your hard line phone is actually not a hard line phone. It looks like it, but it's actually through the internet as well. Oh my God, you people have an answer for everything. You're taking over the world, you know that? You bought Universal Pictures, the whole movie conglomerate. You bought NBC Television. You're naming arenas after yourself, the Comcast Center, the Comcast, the Xfinity Center. And there's no such word as Xfinity. You made it up. She says, I know, Mr. Van Damme. We are taking over the world. We're owning everything. We own you. You can't escape us. You can't escape the gravity of the situation. You will pay us what's on that bill, Mr. Van Damme, because you have nowhere to run. You're screwed up the ass, as I told you earlier. But I mean big time. You have no choice. You are Comcastable. You have become an Xfinity person, and you can never leave because there's nowhere to go. Let me ask you a question, Mr. Van Damme. Do you enjoy television?
Well, yes, I do. I do enjoy television.
Then you have no options. You can live without television, sure. You can stream all you want, but you still have to have internet and Wi-Fi to stream. You can't stream without that, you foolish man. We control your Wi-Fi, your streaming, your everything. Let me ask you a question, Mr. Van Damme. Do you enjoy going to the bathroom?
Yes, I love going to the bathroom. It's so soothing and wonderful.
We own the toilets. We bought all the toilets in the country. You can't flush without a surcharge, sir. You're screwed. I suggest you hang up the phone right now, Mr. Van Damme. Take your little humor show and go with yourself and sit in a corner and think about it really hard. Do you really want to challenge us? Or do you want to pay that extra $30 for the next year and make believe you never called us and we never talked? Because we have it in our records, Mr. Van Damme, that you try to go for new promotion packages every 2 years. We have your chart. We have your medical records. We know your family. We know your every question that you asked Alexa on that stupid machine. So, why don't you just turn around and walk away? I suggest you do that right now. Holy crap. They got me by the balls. And it hurts. And even if you're a woman, when Comcast has you by the balls, ladies, it's an expression. It's not a real physical thing. It hurts, and it's restricting. I never thought in my lifetime I'd be defeated like I have been. Well, guess what happened? I took out my checkbook. Ron, you have a checkbook? Yes, I told you. I have a hardline telephone. I even have an AOL email account. Don't tell me that. We thought so much of you previously. Well, not just AOL. I have other things, too.
Yeah, but still.
I took out my checkbook and I wrote that check for the full amount that they were asking for. I don't want to wake up in the morning with a horse head in my bed. That's not like a dating thing. It's just it's supposed to be intimidating. Imagine there's probably a lot of guys that say, oh, I wake up in the morning with a horse head in my bed. It's my wife. You know, that guy. It is funny, really, but not to her, certainly. Everything seems to be going weird these days. Nothing is what it used to be. You know, it was a wise person that I talked to when I was younger that said, Ron, they addressed me by my real first name, not my stripper name. They said, Ron, everything changes. The only thing you can count on not changing is the fact that everything changes. I said, okay, I understand what you said, but it was really convoluted the way you said it. But it's true. Change is inevitable. Everything changes. Don't ever Don't ever grab onto something and say, this is the way it's going to be for the rest of my life, because it probably won't be. That favorite restaurant is going to close. That store on the corner is going to go out of business. That favorite thing that you used to do every day for most of your life is not going to happen anymore. It's true. It's true. I go crazy with that stuff. I used to love Heinz 57. It's like a steak sauce. It's like a cross between ketchup and steak sauce. I don't even know what it is. It's Heinz 57. It's kind of like a, it's like a light red orangey kind of sauce. I used to love it. I went to the store. I looked at the shelf to pick up a bottle of it. And there where the price usually was nothing on the shelf. It was gone. Everything was there, but the Heinz 57 was not. I panicked. I went to another supermarket, which was not far away. They didn't have it either. I went to a third supermarket. There was none on the shelf. I panicked. I went online and I bought a large quantity of Heinz 57 sauce just in case it did indeed go out of business and it was not available. I would have sauce at least for a while. And I picked up, I think it was 24 bottles of Heinz 57. Don't tell me I didn't feel like a schmuck when I was doing it, because I did. But I was so determined not to have that Heinz 57 sauce end at that juncture in my life. I wanted it to go on. I knew eventually those 24 bottles would go away. I would utilize them and they'd be finished and I'd have to go, I have to live with the fact there was no Heinz 57, but not today, not now. I got the delivery of the sauce to my house, put it away, and I went to the supermarket a few days later, and on the shelf, it's plentiful with huge amounts of Heinz 57 sauce. I have no idea what happened, but I certainly bought 24 bottles at an inflated price for no reason whatsoever. But I panicked because I thought change was about to occur, and I wanted to head it off at the pass. It's very similar to getting married for many of you. I'm very happily involved in it, but many were not. They got divorces. And I know that when they married the person, in their heads they were saying, this is the person I'm going to spend the rest of my life with. That is for sure. I ask you to marry me. You don't say that unless you really think that that's the case. Unless you're Donald Trump, obviously, that's like a lease deal. That's like leasing a car. Yeah, I'll marry you for 4 years. We'll do a prenup. Then I'll look and see what other models are available. Literally. But for most people, when they fall in love and they marry, they think that's going to be until the day they die or the other person dies, one or the other. It's a toss-up. They get divorced 2 years later. Irreconcilable differences. What are those differences? We hate each other's guts. You thought it would last forever. You get depressed. Oh, no, I've lost the person I loved, but I don't love that person anymore. So you move on. You move on. That's what we do in life. We move on. We move on. We move on. We don't move further. We don't move forward. We move on something. I don't know what we're moving on. Sometimes we move in. We'll move into an apartment, we move in. We don't move onto an apartment, we move into an apartment. It's very, very odd. The whole thing's odd. But that has to do with language, and I'm not here to talk about language. I'm here to publicly call out Comcast. Here's what Comcast told me. They have reduced their options for Comcast customers. If you're a Comcast customer, most of you probably are, this is going to be interesting information for you. And don't call them and ask them, because they will kill you. They will literally maim you. They'll do something to your service to make your life a hell, because they control everything. They control the clocks and everything. They can change the time on your clock. Literally, they can. So anyway, so yeah, here's what they're doing. You have to get all the channels. You have to get all the channels. Whether if you like sports, you're going to get sports. If you don't like sports, you're going to get sports. Everybody gets that. Everybody gets like 7,000 channels. You all get that. Your only option is, do you want HBO, Stars, Showtime? If you want all three, you're going to pay like I pay. If you just want HBO, you're not going to watch anything on Showtime or Stars or anything like that. So that's where you can change. Also, and that's it. No, you can't change anything else. And the other thing you can do is you can lessen the number of cable boxes that you have in your home. I have 17 cable. No, I don't. If you have a family, each one has their own cable box, right? It's not like everybody goes to the family room and watches television and then turns it off. In some families, they do. Let me tell you something about myself, just so you understand where I'm coming from. I'm so pissed about this. I was brought up with television. Television was my stability. It was my mainstay. When I was young, I went to a box and I turned it on and I watched shit on the box. It was called television. I watched it every day of my life. Not every moment, but every day. When my parents told me to go to bed, I had a TV in my room, and I would turn the TV on and watch The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. Ron, how old are you? How old are you? I watched TV all my life. When I've had nothing to do, TV was on in the background. It kept me company. It was my friend. TV never insulted me, never hurt me like people do. Ron, you're getting really deep here. Oh, let's face it, people suck. There's a few select people that you call your friends that work out rather well. You have fun with them. They kind of get you. They wouldn't hurt you most of the time. That's a select number of people. Everybody else, you know they suck. They're out to get you and to destroy you. You know that for a fact. You don't need me to do this show to tell you that. Most of my listeners agree with me. People suck unless you choose them out, put them to the side and say, you people can be my friends. You've been vetted. You've proven to me that we can get along. I have a good time with you. You make me laugh. You make me think. You make me you make me feel comfortable. You're my friends. You have a purpose to me. Everybody else, let's face it, they suck. So television, you know, I could just turn it off when I had enough of them. Can you do that with people? You can't turn people off when you've had enough of them. That's an effort. TV, you just turn it off. Push of a button. It's gone. It's finished. Anyway, so Comcast knows that. Comcast knows my vulnerability. You would think that today's world with all the streaming and being able to get things, you know, that, you know, all the different platforms. I don't even know what the hell I'm talking about. You think Comcast would start to get nervous? No, they don't get nervous because they own everything. They own it. They own it. They tried to blame this on HBO, as a matter of fact. The resolving customer service rep at Comcast, I don't know if she was a robot or not, she said part of the reason of the cost increase is HBO. They raised their prices and we had no choice. We were giving HBO away for free with certain packages, and HBO won't let us do that, and they raised their prices. Okay. You're blaming it on HBO, huh? You're blaming it on HBO. You're a large company, you Comcast people. You can absorb prices without batting an eyelash, without clipping your fingernails. I mean, come on. Don't give me this crying poor, oh, HBO raised the prices, and we have to pass it on to the customer. You don't have to pass it on to the customer. You own 50,000 companies. You don't need to pass anything on to anybody except to pass the blame is what you're doing. I think less of you than ever, Comcast. You're pitiful people. But then look who we have as president, so I guess all falls into line. Well, that's it for me today. Thanks for listening. I really don't know what to tell you. I'll be back again tomorrow with a brand new show. Until then, I wish you peace. Enjoy.